Chapter 19 of Buster Bear's Twins by Thornton W. Burgess. The Cubs Talk It Over. Things seem good or things seem bad according to the view you've had. Mother Bear. That is why people so often cannot agree. Each sees a thing from a different point of view, and so it looks different. Just take the case of Buster Bear and the twins. When Boxer and Woof Woof looked down at Buster Bear climbing the tree after them, he seemed a terrible fellow. But when they saw him running from Mother Bear, he didn't seem so very terrible after all. Of course, it was a great surprise to the cubs to learn that Buster Bear was their father. They couldn't think or talk of anything else the rest of the day. "Did you notice what a beautiful black coat he had?" asked Boxer, glancing at his own little black coat with pride. "I like brown better myself," sniffed Woof Woof, whose coat was brown like their mother's. "He really is very big and handsome," continued Boxer. "And a coward," sniffed Woof Woof. "You noticed how he ran from Mother Bear." "That was because he discovered his mistake about us. Of course, he wouldn't fight then," Boxer said in defense. "I don't care. I think he is a poor sort of father, and I'm not a bit proud of him," persisted Woof Woof. "I hope I grow up to be as big and handsome as he is. I'm glad my coat is black," Boxer declared. "Huh," sniffed Woof Woof. "A black coat may cover a black heart. We are lucky not to be inside that black coat of his right now." This was true, and Boxer knew it. He wisely attempted no reply. "Where do you suppose he lives?" he ventured. "I haven't the least idea, but I hope it isn't near here. I don't want to see him again ever," retorted Woof Woof. "But he is your own father," protested Boxer. "I don't care. If all fathers are like him, I don't think much of fathers," sputtered Woof Woof. Mother Bear came up just in time to hear this. "Tut, tut, tut," said she. "I won't have you talking that way about your father. By and by, you will know him better and learn to respect him. He is the handsomest bear I have ever seen, and someday you will be proud that he is your father."
"I like mother's best," confided Woof Woof, snuggling up to Mother Bear.
Mother Bear's face suddenly grew very stern. "I want to know," said she, "how he happened to find you up that tree."
We met him, and he chased us up that tree," explained Boxer.
"And how did you happen to meet him?" persisted Mother Bear.
"That tree was a long way from where I left you at play and charged you to stay."
The cubs hung their heads.
We found his tracks and followed them," stammered Boxer in a low voice.
"And got a fright, which was no more than you deserved," declared Mother Bear. "You ought to be spanked, both of you, for your disobedience. Now you see what comes of not minding. I hope the fright you have had will be a lesson you never will forget. And don't let me hear you say another word against your father."
"No'm," replied the twins meekly.
End of Chapter 19.